Ladies and gentlemen, at the Wurlitzer of the Tower Ballroom, Blackpool, Phil Kelsall. Phil begins his program with Tiger Rag. Bouncy, breezy fun resort of the Northwest, where the world and its wife and the family come in their millions to soak up the sun and get those famous sands between the toes. And that magnet for millions, the tower itself, the home for over half a century of the mighty Wurlitzer. In the capable, and in the next number cavatina, the sensitive hands of Phil Kelsall. Whenever organists get together, if they're not talking about their music, then the topic of conversation is sure to be the organ itself. Phil, here with fellow organist and presenter of the radio program The Organist Entertains, Nigel Ogden, could go on about the Tower Wurlitzer for hours.
You can buy two Rolls Royces for the money it cost to build. But yes, now it is in perfect working order.
And that was all done during the winter season?
Oh, it's got to be, yes, because it's summer. Yeah. It's played every day.
But during the summer, everything's been in full working order.
That's right.
Yeah.
It is now. Yeah.
How does it do for tuning? Do you find it holds its tuning pretty well or not?
Well, it's always a problem. But as you know, we're getting a bit technical now, but some of the Kinyora and the Crummet, which are like a medieval sound, they go out of tune very, very quickly. And the temperature, when like today, a nice day, the temperature rises, that affects the orbit as well.
Well, it's amazing. I mean, without getting too technical, obviously, because I don't
know
technical.
No, neither do I.
No, we're very limited in that. But you go up into the chambers, I mean, it's amazing the small space that it's squashed into. I mean, 14 racks is not a small one. I mean, it's a fair size thing, but I mean, the chambers themselves are really small.
Those chambers, Nigel, were built for the original orb, which was installed before this one, which only had 10 racks, which was a lot smaller orb. But they crammed, apparently Reg Dixon wanted a bigger organ than this, and he couldn't have it because there simply wasn't room up in the chambers.
It's all there. I can just imagine one of these days.
Like his predecessors, Phil carries on the tradition of releasing recordings made at the Tower. And these have proved popular not only with lovers of the organ with its typical Blackpool sound, but also with those who like a bit of good music to get up and dance to. In fact, each and every day during Blackpool's long summer season, the Tower Ballroom echoes to the sound of Phil's music for dancing.
One of the most popular dances of them all is the St. Bernard's Waltz. Come to our next dance, which is the quick step. theme, the birdie dance next.
From the ever-popular birdie dance, what else is Phil asked to play?
Well, there are several of them. I think number one on the hit parade of popular tunes must be Spanish Eyes, followed closely by Viva España, Beside the Seaside, and this next tune, which I'm going to play for you, it's called, well, it's an old Glenn Miller standard called Chattanooga Choo Choo, but we can use the organ to very good effect by getting the imitation of the train, using the loud stops and, as you see, playing at the bottom end of the keyboard to get the train effect. And here we go with Glenn Miller's Chattanooga Choo Choo.
Chattanooga Choo Choo, reminding us of the power and versatility of this astonishing music machine. When Phil first visited the Tower Ballroom at the age of 8, the Wurlitzer was in the hands of the legendary Reginald Dixon. And within a few short years, Phil too was thrilling audiences with his playing. But the Blackpool Holidaymakers had to wait until the late 70s before this magnificent ballroom was to be filled with the sound of the Tower Wurlitzer, played by Phil Kelsall himself. The present-day organ has been here since 1935, and its unique sound can be attributed as much to the cathedral-like acoustics of the ballroom as to its special quint and tier stops. Lovely memory from the musical Cats. Whether for dancing or just for the thrill of listening, the playing of Phil Kelsall is sure to be a memory. A memory that many will cherish. And to round off our program, what could be more memorable than Phil tackling the terrors of his own arrangement of 12th Street Rag.